Hello everyone, and welcome back to more Let's Play Alundra. We left off on this puzzle. This puzzle is not too difficult if you read the sign. Pretty easy to figure out what we need to do. We need to make a tower. Just like that. Most of you who did attempt to figure it out managed to get the correct answer. Now, we're almost done with this dungeon, but there are still a few puzzles left. Puzzles like these. See, here you have to put all the blocks in the right spot and also time it correctly. Which is not too difficult, but can be a hassle at times. I'm not a fan of it, I can say that much. Not a fan. Then a random avalanche starts happening, I don't know why. And now you can see the sand has been lowered and yeah. We got another hole to go into, and it's, again, one of these puzzles. This time it's reversed. Last time we wanted to put the star on the south side. This time we need to put it on the north side. Okay, let's try this again. Basically, this is just memorizing the way it flashes. And again, as I said, it's the complete opposite for all of the shapes. I'm not really sure how they intended to have you guys find out how to put them in the correct positions, because, I don't know, it just... nothing seems that helpful to me, but... oh well, I guess it's just trial and error. Now, once that is complete... Shrine Protector has now been activated. And as you guys can clearly see, the Shrine Protector is basically just the Ancient Guardian that we fought before. He has the same attacks, basically. However, he is now much faster. And because we are in sand, we are much slower. It gives him the advantage, however, he's still not very difficult at all. Has 75 HP, and using the Earth Scroll does 12. I think I actually managed to hit him twice with the Earth Scroll, if I'm not mistaken. I've never managed to do that before. So that's very useful. Going to actually save the other use of the Earth Scroll magic. Because as you can see, the Shrine Protector is very, very easy. And in no time at all, we have defeated the Shrine Protector. That's really when the Iron Flail comes in handy. I believe it does 3 HP of damage, and... yeah, now we can get out! Now we can escape! And head on to this puzzle. Yeah, we're not done with puzzles yet. Not just yet. This is another one of the puzzles where, barrels drop from the sky. Also, someone told me of this nice little secret. Not really secret, but a tip, I guess you could call it. In situations like this, you can put barrels over other holes so that if a barrel drops on that hole, it will catch it, like you guys just saw. That went well. All we need are 3 barrels once again to press the switches down, and of course use Alundra for the last switch. Now in this room, if you're anything like me, you see the little floor panels there and you think, those are probably spikes. I probably need to navigate this area very carefully in order not to run into the spikes and take damage. And you probably get maybe, I don't know, a quarter of the way through thinking, wow, I'm doing really well at this, I haven't gotten hit once. Well, that's because the floor isn't actually spikes, it's just kind of layers. I don't know why they look like that, I think they very much look like, I don't know, little tiny spikes coming up from the ground, and I fully expected them to do damage. They're actually just ordinary floor panels. The challenge of this room basically comes from jumping over the tiny holes and pressing switches and then getting under the pillars in time. Now, I could fall in the hole and show you guys the little area below us, but there's really no sense in doing that. There's nothing there for us. Just a bunch of zombies and a big open room. A lot of work, and I don't really want to go through that for nothing. Unlike the dungeon before us that had a Gilded Falcon in one of the random holes, which is pretty cheap, but... Oh well, what do you expect from this game, really? That area, however, is not challenging by any means of the word, but now, who are these guys? A test of strength, huh? Can we do it? Can we survive the test of strength? Dear God, they're all zombies! Yeah, test of strength is not too difficult. Unfortunately, I managed to miss one of them. Anyways, finishing off this last guy. Yeah, there's your test of strength. I think I passed. Alundra, it really wasn't that big of an accomplishment. And as we succeed, we realize, hey, that guy was the skeleton we saw at the very beginning. And now we have our three treasures. A life vessel, of course. Always welcome to me. And this. Yes! The long boots! The long boots allow us to walk through sand and shallow water without being slowed down. We can also now make full jumps in sand and shallow water. And I know a lot of you have been looking forward to this. The sword. The sword automatically replaces our dagger and is much stronger. However, there's no actual sprite change. It still looks the same as the dagger. However, we now have a charge attack. And in the future, pretty much every sword, I think with the exception of one, has a charge attack. Charge attack is very valuable. And now we find ourselves back out here. But now we can make full jumps. We are no longer slowed down by the sand. And now I want to head up here. Because there are nice things to collect. And I want nice things. I don't know about you guys, but that sounds like a great thing to get. Nice things? Definitely. In this chest we have... 30 Gilder. And I just fell, and that sucks. But we got 30 Gilder, so that's okay. More money to have. I definitely need to get some more money. I mean, eventually it's going to become pretty worthless, but since I don't actually have very much at all, there are a few things I do need to buy, such as life vessels. Specifically life vessels. Not really a whole lot I want to buy other than life vessels. So now that I've actually made this jump, we can continue on and miss a jump again. God damn it. Okay, I made that jump this time. And over here we've got a Gilded Falcon. That is number 16 for us. Not too shabby. Now we want to head along here and enter this cave. Now we're inside with nice music and a really difficult jump. Let's see if I can actually make this jump. It's very difficult. I hate this jump. There we go. Okay. And what have we got for us at the top? The sluice key. What exactly is this key? What will it unlock for us in the future? What are these red things? Well, we're not going to find out what those are for quite a long time, but what's the key to? Well, you'll have to wait and see next time on Let's Play Alundra. I'll see you then.